In this video, we are going to describe the overview and navigation menus within the new Electronic Filing System web application, abbreviated EFS. We will start by going over what each of the items on the Board of Elections main navigation is, which is located towards the top of the screen. Based on the size of your screen display, these items will either display as a single horizontal line or multiple lines in main navigation, but the order remains the same. Typically, each page in the application will feature a sidebar navigation or filter in which you select choices to populate what is displayed on the page. We will discuss the sidebar navigation shortly. We first select File a Disclosure Report, which is the first option after Board of Elections in the main navigation. This is the page where data entry occurs to create your reports and where we will spend most of our time during many of the upcoming videos as we cover how to enter various receipts and expenditures of your committee. Please note that you are able to enter and save transactions whenever is convenient for you. In other words, you can add transactions, save and log out, and then return at another time to enter more and/or submit. Reports will remain pending until submitted. Next, we select View All Disclosure Reports from the main navigation. You can view all of your reports or partial reports that have been created here. On this page, you will view any pending reports, submitted reports, and amended reports. The filer may select a report row to highlight and see the transactions and details of it. Next, we select View / Submit Disclosure from the main navigation. This is the page where the filer can view a report and submit it to the New York State Board of Elections. In order to view a report, you must select all choices from the sidebar navigation to the left to populate the report. Again, we will review the sidebar navigation shortly. Here, you may view your report in three different ways using the drop-down menu. Number one, as entered, is the default view, and it means the data will display as the user has entered it. Number two, by transaction type, means the report will display separated by the type of data it is. Number three, schedules, means the data will display using the schedules of the old EFS software. Schedules are no longer used in the EFS web application. However, since that is a comfortable segmentation for many filers, the option to view a report this way still exists. We will show all of these views in the video entitled Reviewing and Submitting Reports After Entering Transactions. Please be aware that reports are labeled pending until submitted. To submit your report, please select the Submit button on the top right side of the page. If the report has already been submitted, as is the case we are showing here, the date of submission appears and the option changes from Submit to Amend Disclosure Report. Next, we select View Supporting Documents from the main navigation. This is the page where a filer will be able to see any loan documents that it has uploaded and submitted to the New York State Board of Elections. Historically, filers have always been required to submit a letter of indebtedness anytime a loan has been received, and a letter of forgiveness anytime a loan or liability has been forgiven. This requirement remains in the new system. However, the change is that filers will be able to upload these documents themselves right into the new EFS web application. Next, we select Import Disclosure Reports from the main navigation. This page is for those filers who use an outside vendor to prepare their disclosure reports. These vendors provide services to committees, including creating disclosure reports that must be compatible with New York State Board of Elections requirements. If you do not use an outside vendor, you may ignore this page entirely. Next, we select Loan Reconcile from the main navigation. This page is for those filers who have outstanding loans at the time we transition to the new EFS web application. Before using the new application, the filer should reconcile the loans to map how the new application imports the loan receipt and any related loan repayments and/or loan forgiveness. Lastly, we select the Help page from the main navigation. This drop-down menu provides a list of guidance documents for commonly asked questions about using the new EFS web application. The how-to answers display as pop-up boxes, so they do not take you away from the page you are working on. Select the X to close out these answer boxes. Now let's again select the File a Disclosure Report page in the main navigation to go over the sidebar navigation on the left side of the page. Notice that filer ID, filer type, and candidate or committee name are auto-populated. As a reminder, if an individual is the treasurer for multiple committees and is using the same login for them, all of his or her committees will be available in the drop-down menu. The filer type filter means state level versus county level filer. There are no A and C filer IDs to designate which level a committee or candidate is anymore. These will be auto-populated based on the filer ID. The next filter is report year. Select the year for the report you are creating. And then the election type filter will auto-populate. This describes whether the election is for a state or county level. The report type filter discloses whether this report will be election related, general, primary, or special, or a periodic, or an off-cycle report. If primary, general, or special is selected above in report type, the election date filter will auto-populate. This field disappears if periodic or off-cycle is selected above. The disclosure type options depend on whether the disclosure is election-related or periodic or off-cycle. Itemized report and no activity report are allowable types no matter the report type. If the report is election-related, 24-hour notice and campaign material are options, as is the notice of non-participation, known as the CF20, for certain committee types. This is also where the in lieu of statement can be selected if applicable. Next, the disclosure period is selected to designate the specific reporting period. For elections, this can be the 32-day pre, 11-day pre, and 10 or 27-day post. For periodic reports, this would be either January or July. The cutoff date and filing date fields will auto-populate based on earlier selections. The last possible filter is resignation/termination. Select one of these options from the drop-down menu if you will use the report you are about to create as the final financial report to accompany a resignation or termination request. As always, even if one of these options is selected, a paper CF18 form with an original signature is still required. And a letter of resignation must be submitted by a treasurer if requesting resignation. Once all filters are chosen, select Apply at the bottom of the sidebar navigation to create the report. At this point, you are ready to begin entering transactions. We will go over all transaction types starting with the next video. As always, staff at the New York State Board of Elections is always happy and ready to assist you. Our Campaign Finance Call Center may be reached at 518-474-8200. For technical assistance, our IT help desk may be reached at 518-473-4803.